Hello, Glendale Community College. We are here to wrap up chapter one, and I thought I'd show you Bambi. Look, there's Bambi. You may occasionally hear her barking in the background, so I thought I'd show you Bambi. She's a little papillon. She's about 10 years old. Do you have pets? Pets are a lot of fun. Anyway, we're going to wrap up chapter one now. There was a little bit of something I forgot to mention in the last video, so we got to wrap up this chapter real quick. This is the kinetic molecular theory of gases. It's a theory that helps us explain gases in a way that we can do some pretty neat things later on. If you continue in chemistry into Chem 151, you'll find out. So number one in this theory, gas particles are in constant random motion and move in straight lines until they collide, which means hit, other atoms. Basically, it's like pool balls on a pool table. They're just going in straight lines until they hit the sides or they hit each other, and they just collide and bang around, except in three dimensions. That's what gas atoms look like. They're just going in straight lines until they hit each other or hit the side of the room. They move really fast. Number two, no energy is gained or lost when gas atoms collide. The collisions are perfectly elastic. This just means when they hit, they bounce off with as much energy as they came in with. So no energy is gained or lost. Now that's not quite true, but again, in this theory, it's an approximation that allows us to do a lot of things mathematically later. So we say the collisions are elastic. No energy is gained or lost. They just collide and bounce and keep moving. Number three, gas particles, atoms and molecules, take up a negligible amount of space compared to the space they occupy, which is what we've said earlier, that gases are mostly empty space. The gas atom or molecule is so small that it's like it's a point mass. So we can think of gas particles, atoms and molecules, as though they're just tiny points in space. So a gas is mostly empty space. Hope that all makes sense for you. Those are the three components of our kinetic molecular theory of gases. Last slide, a little bit about gas speed. As the mass of a gas increases, its speed will decrease. This means really small little light gas atoms are going to move around faster than larger, heavier gas atoms. So if you think of hydrogen, H2, two little bitty tiny hydrogen atoms bonded together. It's a really light molecule, so it's going to move around really fast compared to something like chlorine. Those atoms are bigger, so you have two chlorine atoms bonded together. It's a bigger particle molecule, so it's going to move around slower than that little hydrogen. So the lighter they are, the faster they're going to go. And then temperature also affects the speed of gas particles. As the temperature goes up or increases, the speed of the gas atoms will increase as well proportionally. Gas particles will move faster at higher temperatures. And you already knew this, I'm sure. If we have a cold gas, the atoms are moving around slower. If we heat it up, they're going to move around faster and faster as we heat that up. All right, this is the end of chapter one. Hope you enjoyed our chapter one videos. Good luck to you. I know it's the beginning of the semester. We got a long ways to go. Stick with me. Bye-bye.